Hey, what's up guys? This is Anthony from Anthony's Customs, and for this review, we are looking at the Super Action Statue JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Star Platinum 2nd, which is obviously the blue and gold and whatever color combination you want to call it. Personally, I think this is the best, and that's probably factually true. It's just a really cool color combination. Green being the least good. Purple being second best. That's my take. You can let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, but I love this version. If you want me to review the other ones, do let me know. I think I have maybe reviewed the purple one. I'm not sure. Let me know, but I have them all, so let me know if you want to see it. Okay, so these figures are not new. They're very old, relatively speaking, but they do some things really well, particularly look good, and they do some things not so well, which is to have loose articulation and some weird proportion issues, but otherwise they're kind of cool. So I thought, what the heck, let's review some older figures, and I think you guys like JoJo, so what the heck. So let's go ahead and get it off the stand and take a closer look. And this guy stand, by the way, I'm fully aware that I'm saying the word stand. I get it. You're welcome to comment about it, but I get it. I have watched all of JoJo's now up through what is current, except for like a couple episodes. So, I understand the jokes about stands now, guys. I didn't originally, but I do now. When I reviewed these things a long time ago, I hadn't watched the show. Alright, this guy stands, including his hair, about 17 centimeters, give or take, because his hair is poofy. And that makes him about 6 3/4 inches. So, it's a fairly sizable figure for an import. They are generally pretty good size. I know they don't necessarily have good scaling across all of the different parts of JoJo's, but they do within their own parts. Here he is up against a ZCSH Batman, which is your average 1/12 scale, slightly bigger than size. And so he sizes up with them just about perfectly. So that's pretty cool, I think. I like that. And so, aesthetically speaking, these figures are phenomenal, aside from weird proportions like super wide hips. And I know what you're thinking. Finally, a figure company made something wider than Hasbro's eyes are set. And that would be this guy's hips. They are incredibly wide. He has birthing hips for sure. But other than that, and you can kind of hide that in posing, these figures are gorgeous. Look at the metallic gold. There's a little bit of a lighter color on there. It's not quite a silver, but kind of like a pewterish color for his belt and up on the shoulder pads. Very nice. Shading throughout everywhere. Dark blue, light blue. The white. Now this, I did buy this used, and there's a couple of marks here and there on it. I may try to touch it up. I don't know. But all in all, it's just an absolutely gorgeous figure. So nicely done. Very, very well done. Look at the gold line work. Oh, so good. Love it. The faces, very, very nicely done. Very accurate to the style. I mean, this looks like it jumped right out of the anime or off of the manga. Very, very, you know what's funny? Everybody's like, call it manga, not manga, which is fine. That's right. But nobody complains about anime instead of anime. I don't get that. Everybody calls anime incorrectly, but not manga. Why is that a thing? Anyway, absolutely gorgeous figure. Aside from the wide hips, it's great. So therefore 9 out of 10. Lovely, lovely figure. And things like, you can see the pegs for the shoulders, which I understand, but you know, it's still a thing to consider. Okay, as far as accessories go, this guy, as far as JoJo's figures go, has kind of only a few. He has one neutral head that comes on him in the package, and then one yelling head. Both are done very well, very nicely executed, love it. We have some interchangeable hands. We have the two fist hands that come on him in the package, one pointing finger hand, two kind of grapply hands, and then one two-finger long stretchy finger hand. And then lastly, we have a display stand and a speech bubble that says, aura. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to read it, but you get the idea. The stand is slightly yellowish because it's getting kind of old, but I do like the fact that the stands can separate to hold two different figures at once. His is not opened yet, so I'm not going to open it, but you get the idea. It's a nice stand. Yes, I said stand again. So accessory-wise, not the most in the world, but definitely enough, so I'm going to go 8 out of 10. Alternate heads are always a bonus. Okay, time for the articulation, which in most cases is really good. These figures have some unique and nice articulation most of the time, and then some of the time it is butts. So, this guy has a ball peg and a hinge, just like your average Marvel Legends, for the top of the neck. So it can look up and down on that joint, and then on the ball peg it moves around as well. Not a ton, but enough. And then the neck itself on this guy is on a hinge, so it leans forward and back. So you get pretty good range. It's not the best ever in the world. I'm still a huge fan, no matter what anybody tells me otherwise, because I'm right, of double ball peg necks and heads. They are by far the best, but this is a really good, well-executed version of this, so I like that. Shoulder pads are flexible and only connected at the top, so they don't get in the way of the shoulders. Shoulders are your standard ball hinge. You can raise the arm up all the way, no problem there. You do get full rotation because the shoulder pad just moves. So not the best implementation of a shoulder pad, but not many better options out there for this particular style, so I guess that's okay. Bicep swivel is fine. You do have a double jointed elbow, and each of the joints will swivel, so that's okay. If you like that, that's good. Not the best range though, given that it's a double jointed elbow. Still fairly limited, just a little bit better than 90, but if you do need an extra swivel in there, you can rotate at the elbow, so you have that. And then the wrists are just your average ball hinge, which gives you pretty good range, so that's good. We have a single ball peg for the diaphragm joint, which gives you extra rotation, a little bit of leaning side to side, a little bit of leaning forward and back, and then you have a reverse ab crunch, which is absolutely stuck on this figure, so I can't show you. They don't have a ton of range. They just have a little bit. It's not the best. But you do also get a waist swivel, which is also stuck on this figure. Like I said, they're not new. This one is quite old, and it doesn't want to move. But the waist twist does work. I have other ones where it works just fine, so other color versions. So it's okay. This is a soft piece, won't get in the way. Holy crap, how wide are his hips? He has very, very wide hips. And not great range. They are totally encumbered by his belt and the sculpt. So you can't go out to the side at all. Don't know if you'd really want to, but you probably don't. Going forward is not so much of a problem. You can bring the legs pretty far forward, but the belt still gets in the way. They really could have spent a little bit more time designing this, but it still works. It's okay. It'll do. They do go back as well, so if you want to do that, that's good. And if you want to try to hide that in a pose, hide how wide his hips are in a pose, just kind of turn him to an angle a little bit, like that, and then it hides the hips thickness, at least a little bit. But yes, they are stupidly wide. And you do get a thigh swivel, by the way, in case I didn't mention that. For the knees, it's the same as the elbow at the top half. So you have the hinge and the rotation, then the bottom half is just a standard hinge. So you get really good range, but they are fairly floppy, so do be careful. These guys are prone for shelf dives, so definitely use the stands they come with. And then for the ankle, you have a hinge. It's a little ball hinge, so it rotates at the top and at the ankle itself. Not the best range, but it is there. And then you have a little tiny toe hinge. So lots of articulation on this guy. Not a lot of it works especially well, so that's a little bit unfortunate. And I'm not counting the stuck joints. I'm just counting the parts that actually don't function well, given that they're not stuck. So articulation-wise on this guy, I'm only going to give it, I'm going to say a 7 out of 10, because most of it is actually good enough. The only bad part is the hips not having range due to the belt and the sculpt, but the rest is definitely tolerable, if not good, so I'm going to give it that rating. And then as far as the final verdict, well, the fact that it's just so absolutely beautiful makes up for a lot as far as I'm concerned. It's stunning. You don't get figures that have this much paint on them ever. Literally every part of this beside the joints themselves is painted. Every part is painted. Grammar. And so it's gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. So final verdict is weighted heavily towards the aesthetic. And so I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. Definitely could be better. I'd like to see them do a new version. Something similar to maybe the big version, but smaller. Because they did release an all new sculpt for the big version. I'd like to see how that works at a smaller scale. But it's still a really solid piece, guys. So if you're into this sort of thing, I definitely recommend it. And there you go. So if you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, well, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, you may want to, because I have thousands of videos already on the channel and new ones coming out just about every single day. So make sure you come back for that. And in the meantime, keep collecting. All the old paintings on the tomb, they do the stand-down, don't you know? If you